Hey guys, this is Xamarin Guys. So in this tutorial, we are going to talk about bottom tab cell app. So this is our bottom tabs and we are going to use cell in order to reduce the complexity of bottom tab navigation. So at first we need to check whether we are in Xamarin Forms 4.0 or not. So we are in Xamarin Forms 4.0 and the available version is exceeded up to 0.49, but no, we are not going to upgrade that right now and we'll be remaining on Xamarin Forms 4.0 just for now. Now let's go to app.xaml.cs. Here we are going to set main page as our starting page whenever our app loads. So our main page is going to be loaded, then you can see over here you will get your content page. You need to change that content page to cell page. So we will be using cell, that is our main page is going to be inherit from cell page. Now our next objective is to create four pages, that is page 1, page 2, page 3 and page 4. So this set of code is going to be used in order to navigate to respective pages, that is page 1, page 2, page 3 and page 4 from our main page. Now let's create four pages inside our application, that is page 1, page 2, page 3 and page 4. You can see over here, that is our first page and then followed by second, third and fourth. So inside our local namespace cell tab app, that is our application name, we are going to create three files, that is our content page selecting forms. We are going to name it as page 1, page 2, page 3 and page 4, and then we are going to create new content pages. So inside our page 1, you can see we are doing nothing but just creating some labels and giving text as I am page 1, and whenever user selects our first bottom tab inside our main page, then he is going to see all the contents of page 1, and then with respect to if he selects page 2, then he is going to see all the contents of page 2, page 3 and page 4. So you can see over here, whenever user selects the first page, then he is going to be navigated to page 1. Now let's go to our main page. Our cell has tab bar property, so it is defined inside our cell page, and inside our tab bar we have set of tabs. So in order to define those tabs, we are going to give tab as title as order and then icon as 1.png, and this 1.png I'll tell you later from where I got that thing. Okay, and inside those tab we are going to add the content for our first page, second page, third page and fourth page. So these are the images that need to be added from our Android Asset Studio. You can use any third party libraries. For this demo I am using Android Asset Studio, and then selecting tab icon generator. You can select any icons as you like and give name as 1.png, 2.png or anything you may like. And then if you are giving name as 1, then it will be downloaded as 1.png. You can see over here, if you give name as 1, then inside SDPI you will get 1.png images, and you need to add all those images to respective folder. For this demo I am just adding it inside the drawable folder, and you need to add those images inside the resources folder of iOS 2. So we have added title along with icons for our tabs. These are our icons and along with the titles. So for each specific tabs, whenever user select those tabs, he wants to navigate to first page, second page, third page and fourth page. So this local namespace is going to help us in order to navigate whenever user select specific tabs, that is tab 1, tab 2, tab 3 and tab 4, he is going to be navigate towards our first, second, third and fourth page. That's all. So at last let's run our project. this is our final output. That's all. Thank you guys. Thanks for watching. Keep in touch for next tutorials.